Hey, what's up guys? This is Yasser with another video, and in this video we'll study about Finkelstein reaction. Okay. So we study Finkelstein reaction under the topic called as halogen. Exchange reaction. Okay, let's see the general reaction first. What happens in this? So you take an alkyl halide, react it with sodium iodide in presence of acetone. It results in formation of alkyl iodide plus sodium halide. Here the halide is, it can be fluoride, can be chloride, or it can be bromide. Okay, now like one by one we'll study all the things. Now first we'll study solvent. The solvent used over here is acetone, which is a polar osmotic solvent. Let me draw its structure. Okay, so it is a polar osmotic solvent, so it does not, you can say, solvate the anionic part. Does not solvate the anion, so order of nucleophilicity is fluoride ion is the strongest nucleophile among all nucleophile, that is halides. Okay, so now students are having big question mark over here. That's a, then how can iodide ion replaces fluoride, chloride and bromide? Okay, so let me tell you a very important thing. Here the magic is being done by acetone. We know that acetone is a polar osmotic solvent. At the same time, according to theory called as like dissolves like, NaI is the most soluble one. NaI is the most soluble one. It is the most soluble because it is having highest covalent character. It is having highest covalent character. Now, if you want to know about the covalent character, it can be explained with the help of a Fajan rule. Okay, if you don't know Fajan rule, you can just go through my playlist. There is an video related to it, so you'll come to know about it. Let's move further. So in Fajan rule, what we have seen, compared to sodium fluoride, sodium chloride, sodium bromide and sodium iodide. Okay, sodium iodide is having highest covalent character, because we know that as the size of anion increases, as the size of anion increases, covalent character keeps on increasing. Okay, as the size of anion increases, the covalent character keeps on increasing. So this is the most covalent and the most soluble in acetone. Now let's see what happens in the reaction. Suppose we are having an alkyl halide and we react it with sodium iodide in presence of acetone. So now we get sodium iodide plus NaX. Now in acetone, the sodium exists in a plus form and iodine exists in a I minus. So I attack over the carbon of alkyl part and halide is being removed. Obviously, this reaction takes place via SN2 mechanism. that is the moment nucleophile attacks, same time the halide leaves. So it is a one-step process. One-step process. Now, most of the students, their biggest problem is, sir, what happens to this NaX? It can be a fluoride, it can be a chloride, or it can be a bromide ion, and they are stronger nucleophile as compared to iodide. So even they can attack again over the alkyl part and they can reverse the reaction. But my dear student, reaction does not follow this way. Like, backward reaction is not possible. Let me tell you very clearly, because NaCl or NaF or sodium bromide, they are existing in the form of a precipitate. Okay, means the ions are not free. So they cannot attack and there will be no reverse reaction. Okay, so the main important thing over here is acetone, because acetone is the one which converts sodium chloride, sodium fluoride, and this one is sodium bromide. I just changed it, it is my mistake. Sodium bromide into an insoluble form and the reverse reaction is stopped. Okay, so we will now take an example so that you can understand. This is CH3. This is fluoride plus NaI, and the medium is acetone. It forms CH3I plus sodium fluoride. Now this exists in the form of a precipitate, so no more free fluoride ion, and that's what, no reverse reaction. Okay, so I think the doubt of the student is cleared. The main doubt was, if fluoride ion, chloride ion and bromide ion are stronger nucleophile than iodide ion, then how can iodide replace them? Okay, so it's not the iodide which does the things, it's the acetone which is responsible for this, because it converts all these three halides into a precipitate form. So I hope you understood the video thoroughly. Okay, please place the thumbs up button, so whenever I'm uploading a video you'll get notified. Okay, and sure, don't forget to share and subscribe my channel. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye bye.